Isaac and his mother lived alone in a small house on a hill. Isaac kept to himself, drawing pictures and playing with his toys as his mom watched Christian broadcasts on the television. Life was simple, and they were both happy. That was until the day Isaac's mom heard a voice from above. Your son has become corrupted by sin. He needs to be saved.
I will do my best to save him, my lord,
Isaac's mother replied, rushing into Isaac's room, removing all that was evil from his life. Again, the voice called to her. Isaac's soul is still corrupt. He needs to be cut off from all that is evil in this world and confess his sins.
I will follow your instructions, Lord. I have faith in thee,
Isaac's mother replied, as she locked Isaac in his room, away from the evils of the world. One last time, Isaac's mom heard the voice of God calling to her. You've done as I've asked, but I still question your devotion to me. To prove your faith, I will ask one more thing of you.
Yes, Lord, anything,
Isaac's mother begged. To prove your love and devotion, I require a sacrifice. Your son, Isaac, will be this sacrifice. Go into his room and end his life as an offering to me to prove you love me above all else.
Yes, Lord, she replied,
grabbing a butcher's knife from the kitchen. Isaac, watching through a crack in his door, trembled in fear. Scrambling around his room to find a hiding place, he noticed a trap door to the basement hidden under his rug. Without hesitation, he flung open the hatch, just as his mother burst through his door and threw himself down into the unknown depths below.
Hello and welcome back, finally, to a new Let's Play. I'm sorry I took so long. Haven't uploaded in a while because my computer was busted and I had to wait for repairs. So yeah, I'm back now, hopefully. I can make up the lack of scary games over the Halloween days with The Binding of Isaac Rebirth that was just released. This is kind of a tricky one because this is not just a remake, but also an expansion of sorts of a game I've played to death. I've played hundreds of hours of Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb, and however, there's supposed to be lots and lots of new content in this version, so I will be completely blind to that aspect of the game, but just so you know, I'm pretty knowledgeable already when it comes to Binding of Isaac. If you don't know, Isaac is a twin-stick shooter that draws heavily from lots and lots of classic arcade games as well as Zelda. Let's try a new file here because now actually we're able to set up different save files, so if more than one person plays on the same computer. Right off the bat, I have to tell you, I'm a little bit disappointed by the menu. We only have full screen on or off, and as you've seen there in the beginning, when you start in windowed mode, it really just starts in that tiny window and you have to resize it every time you boot the game back up, and that's kind of irritating. Secondly, there is no resolution options. That kind of sucks. As well as, well, a lack of mouse control, not just in the menus, but well, you'll see. This is our character roster. Of course, we can start with Isaac, well, we have to. But there are other ones, some familiar ones, some not so familiar ones, which we have to unlock by meeting some requirements in form of challenges. And there is a hard mode, as if this game wasn't hard enough. We will have a look at that at a later time. Let's just jump right in, huh? Binding of Isaac. Oh, lovely introduction screen. So yeah, we're basically on the run from our mom. Yeah. And here's the first problem. You'll see my mouse cursor here. It doesn't matter. In the previous game, you were just able to click on the ground and Isaac would just, well, shoot in that direction, but that's not really an option anymore. Only walk around with WASD and shoot tiers with the cursor keys. And that pretty much sucks because, well, I've just become so used to that mouse and keyboard control scheme. Okay, so every time you start a new level, there'll be a new dungeon layout and new items and new enemies and new bosses. Everything is procedurally generated, and here's our first upgrade. Distant Admiration. We will collect these upgrades and modify the way Isaac sort of battles his enemies, because there are lots and lots of monsters and abominations in this place. One must assume that we are not the first baby that was on the run from our mom. Well, as well as spiders that have taken residence here. This is actually the first new enemy I've seen. Apparently they have replaced the old spiders that can spawn those small ones. That's about it. Oh, hey there! These pots are also new. Can't break them. I guess blowing them up with bombs would be a possibility. By the way, you can see an item counter on the left side. We have money, bombs, and keys, as well as a heart counter at the top, which we don't want to have run out on us. And these are new fly types. Kind of a swarm thing. Not too bad though. Still getting used to these this new kind of control scheme. And something else that's new. Rooms that are bigger than one screen. That might just be the biggest gameplay aspect that they changed. Because running away most of the time was always very, very tricky in Isaac, and this way kind of opens the game up to bigger environments, of course, and better strategy. And here's our first boss, Monstro, with minions. Okay, that's new. The way this game works, each level, we're in the basement one right now, each level has, for every spawn that you get, be it like enemies or bosses or whatever, or items, there is a certain pool of things that can spawn. And of course the higher tier stuff will come when we're going even deeper into the basement, to the lower levels. But yeah, we will encounter Monstro and his friends. What the hell was I doing there? We will encounter him many, many times. And here's our death screen. He's killed in the basement by this thing. Oh, and here's one of the curses. This is actually a labyrinth or XL level. That means that the level is kind of twice the size as normal. And it'll also have two bosses and two like upgrade rooms. This one was just a hello. Was that Bob's curse or I can't remember. Yeah. Always shoot out the fire and poop. Yeah, Bob's curse. So our appearance has changed. We're kinda green and we've gotten 5 additional bombs, as it said there on the item screen. And our bombs will now deal poison damage, which is pretty nice. This game is kind of very, very huge on... Well, everything's random, you know, and you'll just have to take everything the game gives you in terms of upgrades, and really have to min-max everything. And this was my little unicorn, which you will see in a bit what that does. It's, well, you'll see. You'll see. Come on, grandfather fly. Whenever I don't say anything about the enemies, you can pretty much expect that they are not new to the Rebirth version. Also very good that items you leave behind are not wasted, they stay behind until you pick them up, which is not exactly common in games, and I don't know why. Seems logical that it wouldn't just disintegrate. And here's Larry Jr. Oh, another variation on Larry. Just like with ooh, he is aggressive. Just like with Monstro. I've never seen him with minions, and this is, well, Larry Jr. always comes in the duo, basically. Ooh! Interesting, interesting. So he explodes into maggots. Okay. Let's get rid of them first. Larry is kind of one of the easiest bosses because, as you see, his AI is pretty, let's say, pretty random. Sometimes he gets on your trail, but then again, sometimes he just veers off without... Oh, we got Monstrous Tooth. He veers off without any rhyme or reason. And I forgot to use the unicorn. Okay. Monstro again. With minions. Once more. Different ones. Come on, Monstro. I like how they explode into bones and guts now. That didn't used to be the case. Oh yeah, needless to say, this game is very, very gruesome and violent and nasty and all around inappropriate in all of the ways. not to mention sacrilegious to Christians most of the time. So yeah, that's your belated disclaimer. Shouldn't be watching this if that kind of stuff offends you. Yeah. Okay, so next upgrade here. I haven't seen this kind of syringe before, have I? Of course I have. It's growth hormones. Okay. The boils on his face didn't used to look this Jay Leno, but I'll take it. Makes us a lot faster. Yeah, and whenever you you beat the boss or whatever, or take care of the worst enemies, don't just go down the basement without checking everything. Like I said, min-maxing is the name of the game, and I might just get at least some more items or whatever. There's also hidden secrets. There's, well, in The Wrath of the Lamb, there used to be... Well, actually, I should really use these excess hearts I have by torturing myself in the torture room. Too bad I didn't remember how many hearts there were. So I have to go back. That's actually not much... Not really as the torture room, it's more like a sacrificial room. By hurting yourself. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Wasted a key there. Nice. Okay. Let me count how many hearts there are. There's one. And another one. Okay, so I can sacrifice myself two more times without dying. Yeah, you step on the spikes and sometimes it gives you items. Not this time. But we can do it without risking anything because, yeah, we have some excess items. That's the kind of stuff that makes or breaks an Isaac run. By the way, this door on the right, there's the store, which, if you have a key, which I don't, they can buy some more items. Normally, at least, like I said, in Wrath of the Lamb, they used to be... Oh, there's another... Okay. In Wrath of the Lamb, there used to be always an item with 15 cents, and some more with 5 or 3, I think. So, never go into a store without knowing... Ah, there you go. That's her item. Pill, what does it do? Tears down! Fantastic. That was worth it. Yeah, never go into a store without knowing you want to buy something and without knowing you have the cash to actually do it. Yeah, also, pills... You never know what they do until you actually pop them. Okay. Isaac's got a nightmare. Oh, mommy didn't love him. That's too bad. Well, might have picked up on that when she tried to murder you with a kitchen knife. Okay, this room right here at the right side is actually a challenge room. Or I think it's something that's called a mob trap room or something. And it's basically, it's giving you an item for free. Then it locks the doors behind you until you beat like 3 waves of enemies. Which is okay. Normally, unless you suck like I do right now without having a mouse to... aim, they're relatively easy. Also, these dudes, they'll just regenerate, like so, unless you kill kill them while they're down. Ooh, I hate these guys. Loading heads. And down. And that's the mob trap room. And what a sight for sore eyes. Just think of the smell in that room. Like, really. Isaac. His tears are something special. Did I mention he's shooting tears? That's his only defense mechanism. Right. Really do love the lighting effects in this game. The whole look is really, really good. I could do without the pixelation, actually. But, oops, what the hell are these things? Cyclops spiders? What? Okay. Oh yeah, this is a Faith Heart, which we direly need. It's basically temporary health. Once it's gone, it's gone. You can't fill it up with red hearts or anything like that. Temperance! These are tarot cards, and they'll give you sometimes items, sometimes abilities, sometimes. Oh my god! Who the hell are you? Oh no, I'm gonna die here. Ah, that was close. Okay then. Skeleton guy killed me. Really, Isaac. He doesn't have a nice life. And at this point, I'm kind of wondering how to actually structure this Let's Play. Because runs, depending on how successful you're doing it. Nice. Golden key. Golden key will... where is this? Can I get a bomb by blowing up this rock? Okay. What? Okay then. Guess not. I guess they're just there for chain reactions. Okay, that was new, but now we know how it works. So yeah, Golden Key will open everything that has a lock within this basement level. What do we have here? That's a new upgrade. And new obstacles too, like iron pillars, whatever. Aquarius, Trail of Tears. Oh, that's useful. Don't tell me this is like a trail of creep I'm leaving behind that kills enemies? That's really neat. Okay, this could be really useful. Yeah, it hurts them. It actually hurts them. This is awesome. So yeah, an Isaac run, like I said, it could take like 5 minutes, or it could take like 40 if you can actually like beat the boss, the final boss, that is. So I don't know, would you be okay with a 40 minute, or sometimes even more, 40-minute episode? Because if so, I will oblige you. This is the new store. Because 40 minutes was actually kind of my limit on videos so far. There's an electrical cord for 15 cents. That's basically what you get here. Which is a new item, this electrical cord. I don't know. I have no idea what it does, but I can actually not afford it. And there's this donation machine, and of course the dead shopkeep. I'll leave that for later. So yeah, I would greatly appreciate some feedback on that, because I actually want to know how you want to watch this Let's Play. Also, Isaac, I have decided, will definitely be some kind of irregular thing, you know? I'm not really fond of playing it, like, excessively. It was always, like, my go-to game whenever I wanna, I don't know, listen to podcasts or whatever. Got a scab here? Pretty nasty, Isaac. So yeah, it was, like I said, always some kind of background noise while listening to podcasts or audiobooks or whatever. So yeah, that's why I don't want to play it excessively. So yeah, let me know what you think. It's probably gonna be like some time between episodes before you'll see the next batch. I'll upload a couple at the beginning and see how it goes, I guess. Actually, let me see, and I like this music, by the way. Let me see what this donation machine does. Eats my money. Keep score. What the hell? Okay. It's gotta have a purpose. Another dream. Being farted on. Good times. Basement 2. Uh-oh. These are Diglett worms. they're not really new enemies, but they usually didn't show up until like level 5 or 6. I didn't expect them here. Uh-oh. Spiders, I hate them. The spider nets actually slow you down when you walk over them. And another one of these. Virgo, if you're refreshed and protected. I guess they have new ones for each of the zodiac signs. Which is a pretty neat idea. No idea what this one does though. Okay. These are new too, these little wisp type of things, whatever. Nothing in the poop. Oh! Well, actually there was something. Ah! Oh my god! Yeah. Yeah, that happens sometimes. And what the hell is this? Why can't I push it around? Can I break it open? No. Looks like a battery, but okay. Should I use it right now? Hmm. gives me health up. That's actually one of the best outcomes of using a pill. Gives you a new heart container. This is permanent health, that which you can refill. Yeah, they really revamped these spiders, I guess. Yeah. Die in my trail of tears. There we go, monster again, of course. Like I said, in the beginning we will see these guys again and again. I try to lure him into my tears here. My creepy tears. Ouch. Yeah, I can't wait until there's a mod or something that lets me use my mouse. I'm really missing it. Blue cap, HP tears up and something I didn't read. Oh man. That's the kind of stuff I actually was hoping for in Rebirth. That new upgrade, those blue, whatever they are, like blue stars in front of his eyes, I guess he's high from the mushroom. It overrid the bow he was wearing, which, like I said, I was hoping they'd have like a system in place where each and every upgrade stacks on top of each other and is actually compatible with one another. And there was, well, the same thing happened in the first game, and the same thing continues to happen in this one. Yeah, I forgot this scent here. Anything else? Not really. Okay. Gotta get back to the boss. It's kind of tedious sometimes, but that's the price you pay for being thorough. Down the hatch. Third level. No toilet paper! How horrible. Okay, we're in the caves now, and this is actually a very cool thing. What the? Okay, new fire type, which can't be killed by tears. Interesting. Can I blow it up? Yes, I can. Okay. Give me something good. Nice. Lock up! And I can see forever. What does that mean? So yeah, this kind of upgrade room is a double-edged sword. Because you have to... Oh! A first mini-boss! Isaac versus Lust. Lust is pretty easy. Just, especially with Trail of Tears, oh my god. And she drops a pill. Tears up! Very nice, very nice. Very nice indeed. So, yeah, this upgrade room, you have to kind of... Okay then. Ah! Retractable spikes for whatever reason. Cool. This little thing, which gives us infestation, if I recall correctly. Yeah. So Isaac will now spit flies that attack the enemy. But actually not without having an enemy present. So yeah, I keep getting distracted. This upgrade room sometimes doesn't even yield anything good. It's just sometimes it's just small spiders in one of the boxes, but sometimes it's actually good, but you always have to invest the this one heart into it because you get hurt by walking in and out. that's what a lot of this game is, risk reward management. Okay, and maggots. Old favorite. Oh, these guys are new. Okay. They're leaving Crete behind and they're kind of walking torsos. Walking feet without torsos. Alright. This might be a little longer episode than usual, depending on how well I do. Oh, come on. Yeah, these guys can't be hurt unless they stick their head out. Whew, okay. These guys can be pretty annoying. And some more of these guys. Now they're spitting blood instead of leaving creep. Okay. Hey! Hey! I like these red dudes, and also these appear to be double hearts. I don't want to pick these up because it's just gonna fill me up without me getting the benefit of two hearts. Oh, first new boss of Rebirth, Mega Fatty. Okay. Oh, these are poop wisps. I get it. Oh my god. Yeah, here are my attack flies. Eat this. Whoa! Did you see that? Whenever he opens it, like this. Whenever he opens his mouth like that, he sucks you towards him. I have to struggle to get out of his grasp. Yeah. Pretty disgusting, I must say. Oh, that was bad. Should've known you were gonna come down there. Oh, he's more aggressive now. Now that he's almost dead. And Mega Fatty dies, and we get a coin purse. Look up, we already know what these do. We already know what these do too. What's this? Unlocked Madeline! Challenge 5 unlocked. Challenge 10 unlocked? Okay. We unlocked Madeline by, Lemon Party. Nice. By collecting heart containers, we unlocked her. See what we missed on this floor. Hey there! I didn't even notice that. Ah, that's it! That's what the pill did. Like, I can see everything. It's like having the X-ray specs in Wrath of the Lamb. I can see the secret rooms and don't even have to bomb them open. I didn't talk about the secret rooms yet. Yeah, there it is again. Ah, that was bad. In Wrath of the Lamb, always on every floor there's a secret room and there's a super secret room. And this is a broken magnet. It kind of works. Trinket. I'll talk about trinkets later. Secret rooms and super secret rooms, they both have kind of a rule on how they appear. Talk about that in more detail as well in later. And apparently, normally with the magnet upgrade in normal Isaac, I was able to just attract items through rocks and through, well, over any kind of obstacle, basically, but apparently the broken magnet doesn't work like that. So yeah, a broken magnet appears to be a trinket. Trinkets are extra upgrades that you can actually switch out if you don't actually like them anymore. And I guess we have enough keys to justify opening a golden chest here. Now it works! Was it just depending on the room, or depending on the ops? Open spaces are so much better for floating heads. Okay. Got a tarot card, the moon, which just teleports us. And another trinket, actually. Matchstick, I believe, gives you bombs. Tastes like burning. Yeah. So you could just switch it out whenever you'd like. Except for one, which we'll cover when we get to it. Let's go. Need a breather sometimes. It's a very stressful game. And a golden key! Uh-oh. Stone heads? They look different now. Okay, then. Yeah. What the hell is this? Looks like a broken cell phone, or something like that. Let me donate some more. A blue map! Okay, so looks like by donating money, we unlock items. Whenever you see that kind of screen, it tells you what items have been added to the item pool. So the blue map, whatever it does, I don't know, will spawn in future things, it seems. And Gertie. One of my favorite bosses, because, well, not with this control scheme, of course, but she can be very hard or very easy, depending on how you actually play it. There's, I guess, like you see here, you can lock her into this attack all the time. Shoots once. And then you just move away to the next side. Basically golden. You should take very little damage unless you're an idiot like me. And of course, if she spawns these red boils that shoot blood, take them out immediately. Oh, and little chubby. Like little chubby. Mom's lipstick, and we put it on, of course. That's Binding of Isaac for you. Okay. So yeah, the game is not like it's not randomly generated, but it's procedurally generated. So all these items, I mean all these rooms, are actually handcrafted, of course, Oh dear. Stay away from me! They are handcrafted, but they will appear in different configurations and of course a different layout each time. Dungeon layout is always different. What's this? Looks like the sad onion, but it's a dead onion! Toxic... what? Toxic aura tears. Looks like my range is a little bit... well, not really. But the tears arc in a weird way, so... gonna want this one. More luck! More luck is never bad. Luck will basically just affect all the different dice rolls that go on during the game. Also, this room I'm standing right in front of is, well, if the other one was a mob trap room, this is a boss trap room, which you can only access if your health is particularly low. One heart or less, and they'll give you a boss grade item, so it's again very high risk, very high reward. Going through the motions, and there's a skeleton. Still don't know what these tears do. Ah. Hate these spiders! Well, they're not actually spiders, they're kind of... they have four legs, I don't know what you call that. Can I actually do something with these, okay. Shrooms explode when you kill them. Gotcha. Bomb flies, I do not like. At least they're predictable. Right. Uh-oh. Troll bombs. That was terrible. Okay, this... okay. I don't actually... I really don't actually wanna keep fighting these. I already have the upgrade, so... now that my health is sufficiently low, let me just try this boss trap room, huh? Oh yeah! Stigmata, I like this. Damage and HP up. So yeah, this is a boss that can spawn. Ooh. Oh, actually, these... the tear effect, they go through enemies. That's good. Okay, now just... oh no. Heap. Another boss we haven't seen here yet. It's actually pretty tricky. I'd rather have had Monstro or something like that. Oh no. Oh no, this is bad. Can I do it? Oh no. Oh. So very close. Okay. So yeah. This was our introductory episode of Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I thank you very much for watching. Like I said, give me some feedback on how you want to see this episode, this series progress. And then I'll see you guys next time.